hit that thing. Six. $300 bankroll, guys. CK, Davis on. Hopefully that's not too loud in the background. Yeah, guys, I'm going to be, I meant to go down to Lowe's today. I got my plans together about building, I was going to buy one, but I kind of like to build my own, to be honest. I got 12 boxcar. I mean, you know, it might not be as fancy looking, but I can build a pretty good quality one, though. Just wrapping, see if we can get some monies going here. It's a 314, by the way, guys. I'll bring these up to you, show you what I'm talking about, just because we get a lot of questions about this. And I always say I use decommissioned dice. See, the two has writing on it, just to show you that. Threes do not have writing, twos have writing. See, they have writing on it. Show my shot. Okay, we got four, which pays 9 to 5, guys. Four pays 9 to 5, so we got a $25 chip. 5 units, $5 a thing here. Times 5. 45. Yeah, because it pays $9 for every 5, sorry. Got this stuff distracted. Background there. Put a quarter on the excuse me. Anyway, well, got Tucker Carlson playing in the back, guys. Hoping that doesn't come across too loud. This phone has good better volume than the other one. Got 24 and the 8. The 8 pays 7 to 6 odds, so we're going to get 4 units times 7, $28. We're going to get 30. Well, I said we start off with a 300 bank, guys, so. I am going to turn this down, man. Easy. Thank you. three deuce. Oh, the twos have riding on them. Threes don't have riding. See? Threes have a drill to it. Trying to get that cleared up, guys, because you get a lot of questions about that. Just trying to keep it moving. Okay, we got a $25 chip on the five. Five pays 7 to 5 odds. Pays $7 for every five. That's 35 right there. Soft. Same way. Mm-hmm. Rocking out Friday night, guys. Love to be at the casino. Well, not love, but you know. Rocking out over there. Damn. Hate waiting for the dice, man. It's not my thing, man. Crowd and stuff. Not into it. Okay, we got 60 on the 5. And the 5 pays 7 to 5. So 16. 12 units. Times 7. 84. So we'll be paid. I take 85, give them 1. We got 24 on that one, so 26. Paid 7 to 6 on, so it paid $7 for every $6 bet, guys. So we're gonna get 28 on that one. I'll go 30. Give them a change on that too. Actually, we'll give us one back if we go 50. So the correct payoff is 54 on that one, since we're gonna full press it.
Okay, got to come out roll.
Money's off. However, two chips there for pass and don't pass, guys. Every time I was struggling. Mm-hmm. 3-5, 3-2-5.
It's our 10th dice, guy. Guys, right there, 6-3. See, so it's not a 2. Like I said, the 2s are drilled, or aren't drilled. Riding on the 2s.
Guys, a 9 pays the same as a 5. 7 to 5 odds. Pays $7 for every 5 you put down. So 35, just like the 5. Ain't gonna sugarcoat nothing. I love this when he comes in right here. You can't hear it from there, but love this. Mm-hmm. No sugarcoat, nothing. That's right. Okay, you times I was struggling.
Yeah, man, that shit's hard right here, man. I like this. I fault guys. Be feeling this, man. You just don't know. And times dad was struggling. Tell you what, I feel that, man. So we got a 5, we got a point. Hit a big one. Big payday, guys. 4-1. If I can hold my weight. Okay. 25, 35, 145, guys. Nice payday. I think I marked my first point. 6. So 145. And that 5 pays 7 to 5 odds, guys. 5 pays 7 to 5 odds. So for every $7 you put down, you get paid. For every $5 you put down, you get paid 7. We got 145 there. Find out how many units. 29 units on that, guys. 29 units times $7 each unit. 203. We'll just get into the big chips now. See where this... You've seen the past couple videos. This is normally stacked, but been showing. I'll have to see all this over here if you can see that. Been beating them up. You guys been seeing the videos. I'll say 200.
This is the payday on that 5, guys. 203. We're going to pull back on that. Big money. You seen it here. Dang, this arm.
Alright. So, let's see what we got here. Let's get this pulled down. It's our 11th roll on that one. We're really going to cut it at 10, but we decide whatever. We don't suggest it at home, but that's why I said an average of 10 is great. I'm trying to show you guys what you can do with 10. So we get paid how much? 203. 203. And we'll pull down. Start with 300 bank. There's a little profit we're pulling off here. We'll pull down so you can see the bank. Bank right there. Oops. Pull that down. So we had started off with a 300 bank and we went across with 148. Gave us two shots at it. Okay, so we got nailed on the first one, we can come back on the next one. Well, that's what the goal would be. So I don't know, guys. We don't count that yet. We'll keep on rolling now. We'll get a point. We'll just keep rolling. See what happens here. Where we at? Let's just keep rolling. Let's get that back on. Okay, it's got to come out roll. Imagine that. Hit off the side too.
Yeah, I got the
pins. I go back and forth. Hell, ain't no difference between them building one for me and me building one.
Really, man, be, you know, fancier. They do it whatever, but I can make it pretty nice though. I mean, this is just a little quick little setup right here, guys.
This is gonna be changed at this weekend, though. Should be. Got 10 point. Either way, whatever happens, doesn't matter. We hit them hard on this within our 10, 11 rolls. Yo, we can have 11. Six. Five.
one. Yeah, so obviously our money's turned off. We're just rolling out, guys. We're taking a chance at that. Got a good profit. Got a good 10 right there. Oh, by the way, I did not get it on film, guys, but I rolled. It was a ridiculous amount of 4s and 10s. I rolled 3 10s in a row. 3 10s in a row. 3 in a row. 3 in a row. Yeah, I was going to put it on a snapshot. The snapshot, I was like, you know what? Screw it. It's just not even, you know, for the hater. It said you can't throw 3 10s and 7. I was like, dude. So we're playing the pass line. We get paid on that, but we're not playing the pass line, guys.
You see? Okay, we're still rolling.
It's starting to get a little juicy now. But you guys seen this before. This is my average right here. We're at my average. But it gets juicy because I hit a point, so now we can extend them a little bit. We're hoping. Let's come out roll. This is a different throw. Is that 7 on the come out?
I like when I see him on the come out. I don't know if I'm like, you know, if I like mentally, if I like just am not like super tight focused on the come out or what, but.
Not mine though. Makes me, keeps me kind of sharp though when I roll those 7s come out. So to be honest, guys, I don't mind them. Another 7. Yeah, I've been working on this throw. And, you know, I see full press though in the throw.
And this throw is similar to full presses, like low throw.
But it's different. You know, it's, so I had this other throw where I was doing it. I was throwing. And, you know, I'd throw them and I'd kind of release them.
You know, like release them out of my hand. But, like, just kind of like, you know, just kind of just flipping them out. You know, just kind of,
you know, just kind of flipping them out like that. I've seen that throw, and, you know, I've been using the super grip. I've been using this other new grip, and I'm like, I was like, let me try this. And this throw gets it way down there. I mean, I'm throwing like full press, like that, but I'm not going so low. Like, I think I'm going like full press. He throws like that. I don't know if it's, like, technically like him, but, you know, I'm still getting a little bit of loft on mine. You know, his are like... 3 inches on the ground. Mine are, you know, I'm getting them still, probably getting them a foot up, you know, maybe a foot up off the thing. So, but, you know, I've got a thing where with my shot, you know, I like to get it close to the wall. That's an 8. Come out 8. 20 dice. Load deck. So, yeah, so I'll have to show you guys that one, but it's a, you know, seeing that throw, it just made me think, you know, because I've been throwing the dice since, like, I did this little thing where I just kind of just, you know, flipped them out. I'm like, well, maybe if I hold it, if, instead of just flipping it where my wrist goes like that and it just kind of flips them out, if I just keep it kind of like a straight, hold it out like that, you know, but get just a small bit of tilt, just a small bit of tilt, kind of like an L, like I throw that L so it gets like a 45-degree angle. It's kind of like that. See, full presses fly like 2 inches above the thing. And he hits it like 3 feet out. This roll, this foe gets it about a foot up in the air, maybe about a foot, 8 inches to a foot, and you want to land it right up on the wall. You know, like, I'm literally trying to hit this almost every time. I'm literally pretty much trying to just hit that, you know, sometimes without a bounce. So just putting it out there. So that's the kind of roll I'm doing, so that looks a little bit different, guys. It is. I like it. You've seen the monies being made. That was a nice low one. Maybe about 8 inches up.
Oh, no wonder it's a nice one. Cadillac.
I'll show you guys again.
That 3. So we can crush that out. Right there. Got the 2 on the back with the writing. There's no hole drilled through it. See? Through there, and the other side has the 4. It goes through the 4. See, and the 2 has the writing on it.
Okay. Fourth point, guys, is
we're in the 20s now. Fourth point.
We're still rolling. I am using the dangerous dice set, though, guys. I'm using the dangerous dice set. Snakes.
Definitely got to have control using this dice set. Kind of like that I was showing you guys the other day, the
2442. And I was saying how I don't advise to use that unless your dice control game is pretty tight. I mean, it has to be. It's a dangerous dice set to use. Say three.
Guess we're getting some junk out of there, I guess. Junk rolls. Now that's actual two, see? It's got the writing on it.
You can kind of see it from there. Pick it up.
Bring it over and show you real quick. Just so we can get it crushed out. Better writing on it. See how it's got a writing right there? And the three on the other side. So we've got a two and a three on the other side lined up. See the two has the writing, three has the drilled out. You can see the paint right there. Oops. Three, grab three.
Four, you can see I'm trying to hit that thing. Literally.
I'm pretty much like aiming at the bottom wall, to be honest, guys.
Yeah, some definitely some different stuff than what they teach in the books, that's for sure.
I just knew that was going to happen. Jeez. All right, guys. 5-2.
7-0. Count of money. See what we got going. Hope we got four pairs of dice left. So that means we've rolled 26. Alright, sorry about the dead space, guys. I was texting the missus. Okay, so now we're going to find out what we made here, guys. We did get a 26 for you. Stack of cash. Get 4 points on that. 5, 6, 8, and 9. Using that new throw. Let's go ahead and see what we got. Let's cover up. Another special from Dangerous Arm, guys. Okay. 400, 50, 60, 464, guys.
Right there. And we pulled out that we'd done that, our 11th roll. Our 11th roll put us over on that. So, see it right there. Hundreds are the black. Quarters are the greens. And then we risked 148. Reds are fives. Whites are one. 464.
11 rolls, guys. 464, 11 rolls. So, that's what we did.
Hey, if you like this video, big thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed yet, down at the bottom, there's a board with the dice. Punch that thing. That way you won't miss any of our videos we're putting out. And by the way, guys, I might not get back to you right away. You know, within a day or two, maybe even three sometimes, because I'm putting out all this material for you guys. It just depends, you know, because editing has been taking so long, and I'm really trying to get a hold on that. But just want to apologize to you guys and let you know that I will respond to everybody. We'll respond to everybody. There's no doubt about that. So just bear with us. You know, we might even respond in the videos. So you might, you know, you'll need to keep tuning in, because we might respond in the videos to your comment or question. But I want to thank you for viewing and your comments. Appreciate that, guys. Dice set we used right there was a dangerous one. That was a 54-45 dangerous set. Kind of like the Full Press used that one when he threw that monster roll. 93, something crazy. He's trying to battle for 100. Would love that. Oh, by the way, we got that on the website as well. Go to our website or our channel at the bottom. Scroll through, check out 10 throws by Full Press, and keep scrolling through. You'll see a big card on there, thumbnail. Says 93, you know, Godzilla roll, something like that. So it's pretty gnarly, though. Trying to think. Yes, I was a 54-45 dice set, guys, using a low throw, using kind of like that Full Press way, throwing like that, but I'm kind of just getting a slight tilt up. I'm not going so low with it. You know, we're not getting it, you know, like he likes throwing it ridiculously low. I mean, it's awesome. He likes throwing it probably 2 to 3 inches off the thing. And this throw that I'm throwing is different. It looks the same, but it's different because I'm throwing it about a foot, 8 inches to a foot high. And I'm looking to land it down by the wall, about an inch out, or literally hit the wall with the dice each and every time, where I know his throw was like, you know, flying about this high off the ground, and he lands it out, I think, about 3 feet. You know, like I said, I've seen that throw as a combination of, I've been working on this other throw where I kind of like flip my wrist, not just do like this. Okay, you see how I'm just kind of going like that, where normally you'd flip out like that. This one, you know, you're going like that. But before that, I had been working on one where I like flip my, like I do the same thing, but I see at the end, I bam like that. I do like that. So it kind of gets them up in the air. Well, this, you know, after watching Full Press and I kind of combined, I looked at that. Then I thought about the one how I was flipping it. And I'm like, because that flipping was getting me in trouble. So I kind of am using like a super grip mentality, you know, using this grip going forward with it. You know, so it's, I have to break it down another one, you know, because it's getting kind of long where I can, you know, articulate it and another one, things like that. So yeah, we're using this grip. It's really nice. Flying about a foot off, landing right up on the wall, real tight to the wall. 26 for you. 464, 11 rolls. I'd have to say that probably be the 5 to 10 minute mark. No, definitely like 5 minutes. That'd be like 5 minutes for me in a casino, like 6 minutes. You know, minimum of 2 minutes, two times, two dice thrown, you know, per minute. Something like that should be pretty realistic on the average. But hey, guys, I'll see you next time. CK, Dangerous Arm. We'll see you next time. 5-4, 4-5. Big money. 11 rips. 464. Alright guys, this is CK from Dangerous Arm. I am Dangerous Arm. If you like the video, give it a big thumbs up. Hit the subscribe. If you're new to the station, the channel, what we do is we put out videos every day, fresh material on how to dice control. So hit the subscribe. Leave a comment at the bottom. We'll see you next time. Thank you.